For just a moment, put aside the politics of the military's don't ask, don't tell policy and just consider the sheer cost. According to the federal government's own audit, the military spent nearly $200 million to keep gays and lesbians from serving openly and removing them from service ultimately. Ed O'Keefe is with the Washington Post and joins us now to talk about this. So, Ed, the military spent this money, as we have it here, between 2004 and 2009 to replace approximately over 3,600 troops discharged under the policy known as Don't Ask, Don't Tell. So when we say replace, what do we mean by replace? They actually had to, I guess, bring in new people and train them in the exact same capacity of the people they lost?
For the most part, it's believed, according to these estimates from the Government Accountability Office, that it cost about $185 million to recruit and train replacements for the 3,600 troops kicked out, and there was about another $7 million in administrative costs, paperwork, and sort of other matters. So a pretty significant chunk of change spread out over 6 years. You know, a fraction of the $300 billion annual Pentagon budget, but certainly shows that this was a nine-figure sum, at least over the 6 years, and remember that the policy had been in place since 1994, so obviously the cost has been much greater over time.
And ironically, when we talk about replacing them, just because they brought in new people doesn't mean that they weren't gay or lesbian to replace the people that they lost because of Don't Ask, Don't Tell.
Exactly. You're talking about replacing people who had unique foreign language skills. They may have been part of special forces or other senior military leadership positions, infantry span of all sorts. And there had been a big concern over the course of last year's debate on this, is that there was a large number of people who had highly skilled, techniques and abilities that were being kicked out unnecessarily under this policy. That's what gay rights groups and Democrats had been saying, that, you know, you're kicking out a bunch of people who were willing to put their lives on the line, who had great skill that the military needed, and they were being kicked out because of this policy.
Right. They were willing to sign up to fight for all of our freedoms. Is this value, Ed, completely underflated?
Well, it's hard to know exactly how much money was spent on this, according to the GAO, because only the Army and the Air Force were keeping very close records of this. The Navy and the Marine Corps had to provide pretty much educated estimates. So it's likely that they could have spent more on this. It's likely that it could have been less. And as some advocates pointed out to me, you know, the untold cost or the emotional toll that this took on those that were kicked out and their families is obviously something that could never be measured.
Ed, as you point out, this was instituted back in 1994, but there was never any speculation as to the cost then of what the implications would be, as we've been hearing everybody talk about now with the repeal of Don't Ask, Don't Tell, and what they're saying the cost is going to be as they roll it out over the next several years.
Yeah, there wasn't much of a talk back then about the potential cost of kicking people out, but we know that over the 17 years, at least 13,000 service members were removed for violating the policy. If on average, at least in the last 6 years, it cost about $52,800 to kick out each troop, you can get a sense of the math over time, over the course of that. So it's a pretty impressive sum. Again, a fraction of the overall military budget, but demonstrates that this was, a big cost to taxpayers for a policy that a majority of the country at least didn't agree with.
And this comes just as the Pentagon is expected to detail how it's going to be ending Don't Ask, Don't Tell. In your reporter's gut instinct, do you think that they're going to do a better job of auditing the cost of how the repeal is going to go forward than they did about enforcing Don't Ask, Don't Tell?
I suspect that there will be requests to get a sense of how much it costs to change this policy. Obviously, there's a lot of training. New paperwork has to be filed and authored and distributed. As Defense Secretary Gates said earlier this month, the sheer physics of somehow training about 2.2 million troops is going to be a massive undertaking. It's still unclear how exactly that's going to happen, but we expect to learn details on that in the next 2 weeks. It's believed that they'll start by training top commanders and the military chaplains and the frontline commanders, and then at some point start training the rank and file. But remember, with troops deployed, with others on leave and others getting ready to go, it could take a few months, maybe even a few years, until every single member of the military has been instructed on these changes. We simply don't know, and the Pentagon really, at least until recently, hasn't had an idea of how they're going to do it.
Ed O'Keefe with the Washington Post. Ed, thanks for coming in. We appreciate your time today.
Good to be with you.